Back in the winter, we introduced our 2020 vision, maximizing the yield. And we said that we were going to activate the campus. And we're doing it. Hey, CCMC, I'm Nathan. You know, I stand right here next to the ground that after many years, we were finally able to purchase. And since then, there's been a team who's been actively looking at all of our options, our needs, and asking for your input along the way, as well as carefully and prayerfully planning this process, planning our next step. And today, we kick all that off with our ministry expansion campaign. But before we get there, let's take a quick look back. Some 50 years ago, 37 members combined two country churches to build this current space that we're in. They embarked upon a journey that was 6.5 times their annual budget. You know, no doubt some of those members maybe had the same struggles and feelings that you might have today. You know, is this project too big for us? Can we handle it? Is now the right time? But the thing is, they sacrificed over and above for you and for me, for their kids, for their grandkids, for other family members, for their community, for people that they didn't even know. And now through their faithfulness, we've been able to enjoy this building for nearly 50 years. Back when they built this building, they didn't even know what the internet was. And now today, 50 years later, we're streaming those services all over the world. And so my point is this, as we lay out the plans here in just a minute, these are our plans. These are the plans that we've prayerfully considered that meet our current needs. But just who knows what God will use this space for in 5, 10, 20, even 50 years from now.
Today we embark upon Future Connections. That's what we're calling this ministry expansion. But what does that really mean? Well, over the next few weeks, we're going to talk about many of those things. But for now, let's look at it like this. Think about your friends and neighbors that you love. You care about them, they matter to you, and we care about them, but more importantly, they matter to God. When you're going to invite them over to your house, a time to connect or hang out and just be with one another and have some fun, whatever, what do? You clean up the place, you move the furniture, you spruce it up for them, you might even remodel so you can more effectively host them and make it easy for them to get in and out. And the truth is, they may not be at a place where they would call themselves Christians. They may have no interest in loving Jesus yet, or maybe they're searching for something. But it's that kind of hospitality that blesses people. It moves people. We want you to do that in your home, but we also want to do that right here in this space. To do that more effectively, we need to expand this foyer area. Just look at it. Matter of fact, we're making it approximately 6 times larger than our current space. This is a hub for next steps, for spiritual conversations. This is a hub for new connections. An inviting and comfortable space where connections are made will no doubt have a great impact on the kingdom of God. And another added bonus is that we will have a ground level entrance to get in the building. No more steps to maneuver or ramps that can become slippery, especially in the winter. We'll also include an elevator on the inside as well as to get to the basement or up to the sanctuary. We're also going to make the bathroom larger and more comfortable. And guys, I think you know what I'm talking about here. But more than that, bring them up to today's codes with handicap accessibility. Take a journey with me. You know, if you've been here for a while, you kind of get used to it, but for someone new with a new little one, the nursery is quite a long ways from the action. It's certainly not on the beaten path. It's not quick and convenient to get your child to. The other thing is, in case you haven't noticed, we've got quite a few new little ones, and we're simply outgrowing this one. So we can't wait to move the nursery up to the main level, make it easy to secure for safety reasons, and get it closer to the action, as well as have its own bathroom. Matter of fact, if you ever wondered why the office door is cut in half, Well, that's because it used to be the nursery. It was originally designed that way, with a bathroom. We're also going to relocate our offices and add a conference room that can be used for a variety of different things. Well, we call this Future Connections because we're connecting to where we are today to things into the future. That could be other expansions in phase two, phase three, who knows what God has for us. But we're all about connecting, and we're being led by God to do just that. This expansion is about our friends, neighbors, and our community that we are called to love, serve, and reach for the authentic love of Jesus. This new atrium or foyer space and the other additions will help us do just that. Maybe it's a place where first-time guests can come, have some coffee, and feel more comfortable, not crammed shoulder to shoulder just to get in and out. Or maybe it's a place where people can meet during the week or students can study together. Who knows what ways God will use this space in the future?
Look, we don't believe that any building is big enough to contain the vision of what God is doing in this world. But we do think that God's vision is big enough for a building to fit in it. That's why we're chasing after our 2020 vision, maximizing the yield, activating the campus. That's why Future Connections is happening. Because we're believing and trusting that God is going to use everything that we have to bring His kingdom right here in Cass City.